We were staying in Paris to get away from your parents, and I thought, wow, if I could take this in a shot right now, I don't think that we could work this out on a terrace. I don't know if it's fair, but I thought, how could I let you fall by yourself? Well, I'm wasted with someone else. If we go down, then...
Good morning, friends. It is, I know it's Wednesday, April 12th, and today I'm gonna do a full day of eating. So first of all, I know these do not look appetizing at all, but it's just my normal cream of rice, and I cooked egg whites in it. You guys saw how I made it, but I used egg whites and the Apollo vanilla milkshake protein powder just to switch things up today instead of having the egg whites on top, and then it has frozen blueberries and almond butter. And then, did you guys forget about the days when I used to put coffee creamer on my oats? Because those days are back, and don't worry. This is like the sugar cookie one, and I think it's my favorite flavor, and I was like, oh, it has to have gone bad now because I bought it around Christmas time. Nope, it doesn't go bad until, like, it says September 14th, 2017. So... Guys, coffee creamer has a really long shelf life. But I am going to put the macros for this meal across the screen. The macros that I'm hitting today are 385 carbs, 150 protein, 80 fat, which comes out to about 2,900 calories. So yeah, I have a really busy day. I have to bring my food to school, so I'll show you guys what I packed for that. It's my really long day of class. But yeah, I'm gonna eat this and do some finance homework, and then I'll catch up with you guys later. I'll also give you an update later. So I'm sitting here eating my cream of rice, and I realized my intro was kind of all over the place. I was working on, investments homework with my roommate, like, while I was making breakfast, so my thoughts were kind of scattered, but, I mean, you can't see it now, but you guys know it's a little different than the oats that I showed you guys over the weekend that I've been making recently with just the egg whites. I cooked the egg whites in the cream of rice, and then added some protein powder, just mixed with water, which is delicious. The vanilla milkshake tastes like cake when you put it in your cream of rice. But I just wanted to say it's a little different, and I also wanted to mention that, like, as I get bulking, my macros get really high. A lot of the recipes I show you, you're gonna be like, I don't want to fit that in my macros. Like, you can adjust the amounts. Like, you don't have to use like 75 80 grams of cream of rice. You can use one, you know what I mean? You don't have to use a tablespoon and a half of almond butter, but I do highly recommend putting creamer on your oats. I just like giving you guys general food ideas, and sorry that intro was all over the place. I'm gonna do some homework and update you guys. So you guys aren't even gonna be surprised, because I feel like I'm always running my ass around doing stupid shit. but I realize I have to go meet a group in like an hour, and then I'm on campus for like 6.5 hours for class. And then after, it's my rest day today, but then I'm actually going to the gym just to like catch up with a friend and help her train later. I'm not gonna say like personal train people, because it's just a friend. But I won't have time to like get shit done after the gym, because it'll be really late. So right now I'm heading to get gas, because I'm like on E, and pick up yogurt because I need it for my last meal. Okay, so I got my yogurt. I've actually been buying this one for like the past couple weeks instead of the Faye, because this has just been so much cheaper and the macros are the same. So I don't know, it's good. I like it. I liked over the weekend kind of like answering your questions as I went through my day, because I feel like that way I can like give you guys information that you guys actually want to know that's helpful to you. And it kind of keeps stuff interesting too, since I literally am in school and kind of like doing the same stuff all the time. But the first question I got that I thought
I would answer was from Emmy's Yummies. Love her. But she asked if it's bad when you're bulking or trying to put on muscle to train first thing in the morning if you've only had, like, a snack or BCAAs, like, you haven't had a full meal, if you can still make progress doing that. And the answer is totally 100% yes. It's just, like, your overall calories that matter. So if you're bulking or trying to put on muscle and you're still in a surplus and you just have, like, a snack before you train, and then as long as you, like, eat after and make sure you're fueled and, like, replenishing your muscles, you're totally fine. Just do, like, whatever works best for you, if that makes sense. So I got home, it's like 11:45 right now, so I have to head off to meet with my business leadership group right now. Honestly, the most annoying thing is when you have a group project due, it's like due tonight, and we have class, and you've done all the work and no one else has, so then you have to plan your day around meeting with your group. But yeah, that's what I'm about to do, and I just looked up food really fast to bring to school. So you guys know when I travel, so I keep prepped food, like, super simple. I think that's the best way to do it. So here's what I have. It's just 80 grams of jasmine rice dry, which is like 280 grams cooked, 4 ounces of chicken, asparagus, 6 grams of olive oil, and 40 grams of avocado, which is like half an avocado. So I just have my rice that I prepped here that I just like threw in this container, and the chicken that I made in the crock pot that I also just threw in this container. So it literally just took 5 minutes to throw together. I just steamed asparagus and put olive oil on stuff and mixed it all together and cut up an avocado. And it was that simple. But obviously I don't have time to update you guys right now. Honestly, this is why I hate vlogging when I'm like super, super busy, because I just have feel like I'm like running around and I'm just like rushing, showing you guys stuff. But I will update you guys when I get home from class, which is at like 5:45, 6 o'clock. So that's the plan. I also always bring my water and Rockstar just in case I need it. But yeah, so I got my food. It actually smells really good, and I'll probably put ketchup on it because I always do. And I'm gonna awkwardly eat it in class. I don't know if I'll show you guys eating it. I'm not bringing my camera to school because that's just awkward, but maybe I'll do like a potato quality iPhone thing of me eating my meal in investments class, because that would be so entertaining. Whatever. I do this all the time. I probably bring my food to school like twice a week when I have stuff like this, like group stuff. But yeah. Okay. Catch up with you guys later. Bye. It's like 5:30 and I got out of my last class a little early, which is really nice. And now I'm officially on Easter break. Yeah, when you go to a Catholic school, you get an Easter break. So I have Thursday through Monday off of school, which is hella nice. But I thought before I head off to help my friend train at the gym, I would give you guys a little bit of an update. Oh, I also have to eat too, but you guys are their team. Okay, so first and foremost, I want to start off by saying that I love keeping you guys updated, and you guys know I always share my macros with you guys, and I think that it can be cool to see what other people are doing, and I love sharing my journey with you guys. But recently I've noticed that a lot of people are getting super caught up in like my progress in terms of like weight and physique, and everyone's like, oh, I just want full days of eating and bulk updates or cut updates or whatever I happen to be doing. And while I'm like flattered that you guys want to know everything, it is a little bit concerning in that people shouldn't be caring about what I'm doing more, or like concerned about what I'm doing more than like I'm concerned about what I'm doing. Oh, hi. Because like what I'm doing, it works for me, but like guaranteed it won't work for you. I think if you've been following my journey for a while, you know that my body
is a weird one, and it works in weird ways, and like my body's not gonna react to something the same way yours would. So I just wanna get that out there, and I'm definitely gonna like keep sharing my macros and doing full days of eating and stuff, but I think in terms of like weight and all that kind of stuff, I'm not gonna be like showing you guys my weight and stuff every video, because like it shouldn't, it doesn't really matter. This has to do with like me and my goals and my body, and it won't necessarily work for other people. I just had to change my battery because it just died. But I guess in terms of an actual update, I think I last updated you guys a couple weeks ago, and that's because last week you guys know I was like super sick with strep and stuff, so not that much changed. Last week we increased my carbs 10 grams and my fat 10 grams just because I wasn't making any progress with weight or anything, but I was sick, so I wasn't really training that much, and I was on my period, so like it was hard to know what my body was even doing. But then this week my weight again didn't really move, so we increased carbs 25 grams and fat 10 more grams. So I said at the beginning of this video, but my current macros are 385 carb, 80 fat, 150 protein. And yesterday was my first day on those macros. This is my second day. And I will say, my metabolism is just crazy. So I knew I wasn't really in a surplus. And like I was still hungry, digesting everything super good. When you're in a bulk, at least for me, I'm in a surplus, I can feel it. So I think this increase, at least the last couple days, I feel really full. Like I had no desire to be like eating more when it comes time for a meal. It's just like, okay, I have to eat. But it could also be because you guys know I'm on antibiotics and that like screws with digestion. So I think that that could be part of why my body's like, I literally feel like I have just a wad of food sitting in my stomach. That's just kind of like how things are, but I'm not feeling hungry at all. And I'm assuming in the next few days, will all be like, I'll just get in the swing of things and my body will kind of be like, okay, what's up? We're bulking now. But I do also think that my weight will start to go up this week, which I'm hoping, because I'm just like so ready to grow. And then in terms of training, I got a question about this and on the like post that I posted today. So I train 5 days a week, I take 2 rest days, and what day I do what kind of just like depends on my schedule at school or anything. Like when I have a really busy day at school, I'm more likely to take a rest day on that day than if I don't have much going on. But I have a pull day, so back and buys, push day, chest, shoulders, tries. I have a back and shoulders day, and then I have 2 leg days. And I take 2 rest days, and they are not active rest days, which is something else I got asked. So my 2 rest days are full rest days. I either go in full on sloth mode, which you guys have seen, and I just like hang out here, or I'll just like get errands and stuff done that I need to do. But anyways, I'm going to make food and get ready to meet my friend at the gym, and I'll show you guys when snack's ready. And that's a snack. I have 4 caramel rice cakes. They're just these, with 100 grams of banana, and then 2 tablespoons of peanut butter, and 20 grams of this powdered peanut butter, and then cinnamon on top because it's delicious. And the macros for this are 73 carbs, 16 fat, and 20 protein. Okay, so I'm about to head off, and obviously I'm not taking pre-workout because I'm about to work out, but I was like, I kind of want to sip on something. So I have the Unico Yamino BCAAs. This is a new flavor. It's galactic grape, and I'm not a grape person, but these are really good. Like, I like grapes, but I don't like grape flavored things, but this is like kind of sour. Like the watermelon pre-workout tastes like pink Jolly Ranchers, and these BCAAs kind of taste like the purple Jolly Ranchers. I don't know, but it's really good. So I'm gonna sip on these, and obviously I'm wearing gym clothes. I'm just wearing this white crop top. And then these leggings are Dead Fit Apparel. They're really cute, I'm obsessed. But my friend Kyler owns the company, and I actually ordered these. But I'll put the website in the description box because I ordered a few things from there and I really, really like them. And camo's cool. Camo's fun.
Are we kicking it old school Friday or what?
Yeah, Lance just texted me. Okay, so I don't know if you could see that, but that was Nick.
that was the tool. And I'm really excited because he's coming down on Friday. We haven't done our normal, like, Friday lift thing in forever. So that's happening this week. So expect workout footage from that. And then also, Lance, who's the owner of Unico, is going to be in San Diego. So we're going to be, like, shooting some stuff that I can't tell you, but you should be excited about. So that video will be coming soon, and what time is it? It's super late, isn't it? It's 6:30, and I told my friend I'd be here at 6, so she's probably already training, but yeah, I decided to be social and not wear a hat today since I'm not training, and I'll probably just be here for like 30, 45 minutes, and then we'll go home and eat again, because that's all I do these days. So I'm just chilling on top of the parking garage. Obviously, I did not work out. I actually went in there, and my friend was just, like, finishing up. I guess she worked out really fast. And so I just did some, like, mobility work. And then another one of my friends was there, and he, like, cracked and adjusted my back and stuff. So that was cool. I feel good. I'll be ready to kill it tomorrow. But I thought I would answer one more question before I head home, because I just thought it was really good, and it kind of is about food. So one, she asked someone on Snap. I forget who it was. I'm so sorry, and I don't have my phone because it's charging right now. But she asked if I carb cycle, so no, I don't carb cycle. And two, she said she had a hard time hitting her fats, and sometimes she felt sluggish when she intentionally increased her fat macros. And I'm a pro at hitting fats. Last time I was bulking, I think I was up to 180 grams of fat, like ridiculous fat macros. And I think fat can cause you to feel a little sluggish until your body gets used to it, so one, you just kind of have to stick with it. But I think it also depends a lot on, like, where you get your fat from. So easy ways for me to hit fat macros are oil is, like, a godsend. Like, coconut oil, olive oil, macadamia oil, avocado oil. And then other things is just stop getting, like, fat-free stuff. So, like, get 2% or whole milk yogurt, fattier meat, whole eggs instead of egg whites. Stuff like that. I don't have to play around and see what works with you, but oil is a godsend. And but yeah, it's individual for everyone, and so you just kind of honestly, like anything in this world, I feel like you just kind of have to play around and see what works for you. My whole body just feels like so relaxed right now, like, you know, after you get a massage and you just feel like, that's how I'm feeling. But I'm also still like, I am not hungry at all. So, and I said this before, it always just takes my body like a few days to like even a week to get adjusted to like macro increases once I get in a surplus. So those of you who are like, oh, I'm so full, that's normal. You just have to stick with it. But the meal I'm about to show you, I think that I showed it before. It's just like pasta, but I make it with rice. And I'll show you how I do it, but it's really, really good. And I know I bought pasta the other day, but honestly, just because I'm so full, rice digests super easily for me, so. And I know I bought pasta in one of my last videos, but honestly, rice just digests super easily for me, so that's why I'm like sticking with foods that I know my body does well with in this video. So sorry, it's not that exciting. I just trying to take care of this and get the food in. You are still in my mind. The truth is so hard to find. With all the things that's going on, I lost track, I felt so strong. I got you on my mind, but something's been. Look at that cheese, though. So it's literally the easiest thing ever, especially if you have everything prepped. Jasmine rice, ground beef, you could use ground turkey, ground chicken if you wanted to. And then I just use whatever veggies I have on hand, so I just put frozen broccoli and mushrooms and spinach. And then I used a serving of this garlic, roasted garlic marinara sauce. I put 5 grams of olive oil just because I needed the fat like I was talking about earlier, and then some mozzarella cheese, and I just put garlic powder and salt on it because I literally put salt on everything. Macros. I'll put the macros to this meal across the screen, but I'm going to start editing
this vlog because I don't have to do homework. And then I just have one meal and a glass of wine later because I'm celebrating my weekend. Time flies when you're editing, and apparently weird shaped buns are a thing when you're editing too. But it's 10:30 right now, and I have my wine, and this video is hella long. I am so sorry. And I've covered it before, so I'm not gonna go into great detail about how I track my wine, but you can track it as 30 carbs or 14 fat, or what I'm doing today is splitting it down the middle. So I'm tracking it as 7 fat and 15 carbs. And it's hitting the spot. It's officially my break. So cheers to that. And cheers to calories that are easy to get down. So it's really late right now. It's like 11:50 and my computer is just being a bitch. I have like, it's all, the storage is all full. So I'm like trying to free up a bunch of disk space right now. But this vlog will be up tomorrow and I'm just about to make my last meal and pass out because I just don't want to edit anymore. But I'm making my normal yogurt bowl. So what I do is the base is just, I'm gonna use 260 grams of this plain Greek yogurt and then I mix it with 7 or 8 grams of this pudding mix. So that is what the base looks like. And I know it sounds weird, like why mix Greek yogurt with pudding mix? But I swear everyone who's tried it freaking loves it. So give it a try. I also added a little bit of stevia. And then toppings is obviously the important part. I'm not going to bed just eating plain Greek yogurt, okay? I use 30 grams of cocoa pebbles, 15 grams of Lucky Charms, like 5 servings of whipped cream, one of these, and 20 grams of peanut butter. And there we have it. So, I go ham on dessert. I love my toppings. I love my bowls of stuff. And I'm going to eat this and catch up on some YouTube videos. Oh, and I'm also gonna add the whipped cream. I just didn't wanna hide the toppings from you guys. And literally 5 servings of whipped cream will like cover this whole bowl. I'll put the macros for this across the screen. The macros that I hit for the day, I believe I hit them all on the head. Yep, we had 150 protein. I went 386 carbs. I was 1 gram over on carbs. 79 fat. So I was 1 under on fat and 25 fiber, which is just what I like to do. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I have the next few days off. So hopefully I'll be able to get some fun stuff up for you guys. And like I said, I don't want anyone to think that like my macros are gonna work for you or whatever. I just like sharing my journey and I think that this like YouTube's a really cool platform to be able to do that. But I do this because I want to help you. So if you have any suggestions for videos that would actually be like very helpful for you, please, please, please let me know. But I hope you guys enjoyed this one. As always, please comment, share, like, subscribe, all that fun stuff. And I'll see you guys in the next one, which should be very soon.